Over the last year and a half, the coronavirus has dominated headlines and the medical field.
But now that the vaccines are here, one Milwaukee mother wants people to remember there's another health crisis being dealt with, and that is lead poisoning in children. Fox 6's Cassidy Williams has more on this mother's message tonight.
Replacing dirt with more dirt. It's a delicate process to keep Deanna Tyler's children safe.
After they did their assessment on the house and they told me everything was done, when it came hot outside, me and my kids play outside, and when I get Machiavelli tested again, it jumped really high, and I knew it was the backyard.
The soil behind Tyler's home tested positive for lead, contributing to high lead levels in her son.
As a mom, you know, you want to protect your kids all the time, and that's something I could not control, and I felt really bad for him. He didn't want to eat, he was frustrated, and it was really bad for me.
But because she took the initiative to get her son tested, 16th Street Community Health Center is helping her through the abatement process.
If you don't know that your child is lead poisoned, you can't really do anything about it.
The center's lead outreach program is still only doing virtual home visits to find sources of lead, but families can make an appointment to come in and get a test.
We shouldn't lose sight of some of the other issues that we worry about in medical care. I think lead still is happening. You know, being in a pandemic, people were inside, they were going to be inside, and we still get a lot of patients who get exposed from the home environment.
16th Street says its testing rates in 2020 were similar to that of previous years. But across Wisconsin, a CDC report found 75% fewer kids were tested in April 2020 versus April 2019.
I think a lot of patients were holding back on having their physical exams done, their annual exams done, and I think that kind of poured over into other delays in care, such as retesting with leads.
Symptoms of lead poisoning can vary greatly, and some kids show no symptoms at all. Tyler wants other parents to remember, no matter what else is happening in the world, lead testing should always be a priority.
It should be that serious for every parent. Like, if you don't take it serious, I don't care if it's, you know, storms outside, you take your kid and go get tested, because it's so serious, it affects them so much.
With photojournalist Jade Birch, Cassidy Williams, Fox 6 News.
Cassidy, thank you. If you'd like more information on how to get tested and what to do if there is lead in your home, just head over to our website. Go to fox6now.com. When you're there, click on this story.